Hi guys, I'm Akriti. Welcome back to my YouTube channel. I hope you all are doing well and are keeping safe. So now that we are back after a really, really long time, I was away for a long time because it was the wedding season. And if you know, and if you also do not know, I'm a hair artist by profession also. So the wedding season kept me busy, and I have been on a break for about 3-4 days. So I was occupied and I did not have time for YouTube. But then I wanted to come back with some good information, something that is useful for all of you, if not all of you, for some of you. So I shopped for a few things during my Nykaa sale. So those things were just not random picks. I have researched for them thoroughly, and then I have bought these products. So without any further ado, let's get into the video. So to begin with, I want to show you the Plum body loving gel body scrub. So this is what the packaging looks like. So this is the texture. It is a gel like thing, and it has those small, you know, I guess these are fruit extracts or something. But when you rub that against your body, it's very gentle, and the smell is amazing. I mean, the fragrance is amazing. This is driving me cherry. So the smell was wow. And this is the texture. It is a jelly-like texture. And I have used this for about 3-4 times since I purchased it. So it was a good buy for me. I had been looking for something that could be gentle on the skin, but could also clean, like make me feel clean. And also if the fragrance lasted longer. So this is something that you guys must really try out. And during the sale, I also got this small Plum body oil. It was a freebie, so who doesn't love freebies? So this was one of the freebies that I got on purchase of the Plum body gel scrub. So that was all about it from Plum. Earlier I had also gotten Plum's body wash, which was Hawaiian Roomba. I have been using it, and it's just wow, like lathers well. The fragrance is not that high so that you get a headache, but it's very gentle. And overall, by far, I have used these two products, and I think Plum is doing really well. So that was all for the Plum. Second, we come to, since I already mentioned that I'm a hair artist by profession, and I also get people who have gray hair and they want a quick fix. So in my previous video also, I had purchased L'Oreal Magic Retouch. It is in the shade dark brown. Just spray this over the gray hair if you are in a hurry, and it provides good coverage. Like it's you cannot distinguish if it is your real hair or if you have sprayed something. Just cover up the area on the scalp, whichever you want to, and you're good to go for any of the occasions that you want to. I prefer buying gold. This, which color is it? I prefer buying dark brown because most of us do not have extreme jet black hair. So when you apply dark brown, it is somewhat, you know, going to cover up the place without leaving any hint behind that you have done something to your hair. So I think that is one of the best aspects of it. And if you have like jet black hair, you should go for obviously the black color. So L'Oreal Magic Retouch, it's this spray, like does wonders. So this is, I guess, my third bottle or maybe fourth, and I've also gifted my mother 2-3 bottles of this one because why not? So yeah, that is all about the L'Oreal Magic Retouch. Next up, I bought the Minimalist sunscreen. So I have purchased 2 of the Minimalist sunscreen because I was earlier using Neutrogena's sunscreen and it stings the eyes. I don't know what is wrong, but then earlier whenever I used the Neutrogena's sunscreen, if I used it close to my eyes and if I went out in the sun, I would just cry, like something would hurt in the eyes and I would cry. So I was looking for something that would not hurt my eyes, not sting my eyes, and not leave the, I do not want the white cast also. So no doubt that Neutrogena's sunscreen is good, but due to some reasons I think it did not suit me, and I also asked my relatives to use it, but then it had the same effect on them also. So I thought it's not just me, maybe there is something up with the formulation. So I wanted to try for something which is very different, which is not going to sting my eyes and also not leave a white cast, and had gel like quick absorbing formula. So then I read about the Minimalist sunscreen and I used it thrice. I applied it all over my face, even close to my eyelids, and I went out in the sun and I did not cry. I did not cry. And earlier people used to think I'm crying, but actually it was the sunscreen that was making me cry. So right now, no more crying. It does not leave any white cast, very quick absorbing formula, and it also has like a broad spectrum, so I do not have to worry about that as well. So it is paraben free, sulfate free, fragrance free, like ticks all my boxes. So I really wanted to try this sunscreen, and if you're looking out for a good reasonable sunscreen, like if you have a certain budget assigned, I think you should go with it. And like, what do you need to do? It has the instructions also, like it after you do your cleansing, toning, and putting all your serums and moisturizers, then you can put this sunscreen. I went for SPF 50, and it also saves you from the UVA and UVB sun rays. And what else? Goodbye. Really goodbye. I think I have been using Minimalist products for the past 3 years, and they have honestly made a huge difference to my skin. Earlier I was using the niacinamide serum for my skin and my pores had healed like a lot. I had lots and lots of acne scarring on my face, but after using Minimalist the niacinamide serum, it did wonders to my skin. So right now I will go with the SPF 50 sunscreen of Minimalist, and if you are looking out for a good sunscreen that does not leave a white cast, it's quick absorbing and does all the job that a sunscreen is supposed to do, I think you should go with this. So next up, this was like a very spontaneous buy. I did not think about buying this product, but then a relative of mine, she purchased this product and I liked it a lot, like for such a reasonable price. I mean, why not? So this is the Love Earth Liquid Mousse. It has got 9 mini lipsticks. Yes. And these are matte finish and mostly all of them are nude in shades. I mean, please give Love Earth an applause, because it's very difficult to, you know, find good lipsticks in the market at such a reasonable price. This miniature pack of 9 has liquid lipsticks of 2 ml each, and it has all the shades, like all the shades that would be required by somebody like me at least. So it has the red color also, pink color also, but then it has all the shades of nudes as well. So I used this day before yesterday, and I used this quite a lot of times, because since the day this has arrived, I have been using only this. It is a matte finish lipstick. You can use this, like you can even mix and match the colors. Like I always do this to my lipsticks. Like I mix and match them. If I don't like the shade, maybe I go a little darker on the shade, or maybe go a little lighter on the shade. But I do go. So it's very quick drying, does not chap your lips, and the best part is this is for something it is for one triple line, but then during the sale I just got it for 9.99. like for 1,000 rupees you are getting 9 lipsticks. Who wouldn't like it? And I'm very fond of matte lipsticks, so this was good for me for office use, or maybe I'm just heading onto a party or something. I think this is just perfect. You could even slip just a small lipstick into your bag if you think you need touch up or something. So this is the size of the lipstick, and they have given nice. Just look at this. I mean, wow. And I just love something that is in square, like this packaging. Even the Huda Beauty foundation and everything, I think they are in squares. So I like something that is in square. Is just throw this in your bag and you're good to go. So yeah, this was all about the Love Earth matte lipstick. So next up, I'm going to be talking about the Too Faced Born This Way foundation. So I bought this by trying out in the Nykaa store during the sale. So when on the day the sale was about to begin, me and my cousin, we headed out to the Nykaa store, and I was very confused regarding my shade. So I do not want to buy any foundation which does not match my skin tone, because you know, Too Faced foundations are expensive. So we just headed out to the store. I tried lots and lots of products. I think I tried foundations of K-Beauty this. I tried foundations of Too Faced. I tried foundations of Bobbi Brown. And I think my best decision was to buy the Too Faced foundation. I tried K-Beauty's foundation, but then K-Beauty's foundation is not medium coverage also. Somehow I did not like the finish. I mean, when I was dabbing it on my skin, the entire foundation almost came out on the blender, and it did not blend well on my face, as if not even the concealer. Forget about the concealer. I mean, the foundation did not do its job as it was supposed to. I had really high expectations from K-Beauty foundation. But then I did not like it somehow. I ended up just leaving it because I was planning to buy that. And I think K-Beauty can do a good job on the foundations, because the rest of the products, I think they are very nice. So then after that, I was looking out for foundations in the store, and I really liked the Too Faced Born This Way foundation. It just blends into the skin perfectly. It does not feel like you have put a mask on. It is very lightweight. It does not feel heavy at all. And it has some really nice ingredients like the coconut water, alpine rose, and hyaluronic acid. So these products, definitely if they're infused with such components, it does make a lot of difference to your skin. So I did not feel like I have put a foundation and it was making me feel like I have put a mask on. and I did not feel any different, but it also gave me confidence because some of the spots that I wanted to be covered, it just covered it immediately, and it just did not leave a spot. Like, I don't know, there's something up with the foundation. So this is a medium to full coverage foundation, and if you are willing to purchase a foundation and if you want to invest in a good one, like if you are ready to go for an investment like this, I think you should really try out the Too Faced foundation. I am in the shade warm beige, and I don't know, I am just in love with this. From the day this has come to me, I have been trying this and heading out for parties, for different meetings. I also thought of buying a Bobbi Brown's foundation, because even Bobbi Brown's foundations are really, really good, like really good. But then I did not have my exact shade in the store. So if you want to buy a foundation, please, and if you're not sure, like if you are sure and if you are repeating the same foundation, then it's fine. But if you are going to buy a foundation of different brand, I would suggest just head out to a store, just match your foundation, and it is not suggested that you check your foundation on the neck or here on your wrist, because these spaces are supposedly lighter in complexion compared to your face. So it's preferable if you try and check the foundation on your skin over here and here, and then make it a buy, like then purchase it. So I do not want to make that mistake of buying products like foundations online. So I headed out to the store, I checked my shade, and then I made that buy. So this one was one of the best buys for the year, and I was lured to the Too Faced counter. So then I also bought the Too Faced concealer. So again, I'm in the shade warm beige. I do not want to buy the lighter one and the deeper one, because I already have it from the other brands and I do not highlight my face that much. So I went for the super coverage concealer, and it is again hydrating, long wearing, photo friendly, and non cosmetogenic. Basically, it will not clog my pores. So I just looked after the formula, and I applied it under my eyes to check if it really worked, and I could see the difference. Like, I had a line over here under my eye, and I applied it in the same way on my right eye, like under my right eye, and I could see the difference. Like, it made a huge difference to my face. It just covered the face in the way I would really want the concealer to do its job. So Too Faced concealer and foundation, if you are like willing to invest in a good foundation and a concealer, I think I will give it a 11 out of 10 for the formulation and everything. So that was all about it. I hope you guys gathered some information, and I hope it helped you guys in some way or the other. And if you guys have any questions regarding any of the products, please comment down in the section below. I would be really glad to help you all. And these are my personal recommendations, and I have tried these products, and only after that I've purchased and also done this haul on the Nykaa sale. So these are all tried and tested products, and I do not endorse them in any way, but then I just want to share with you any information that could be helpful in any manner. So thank you all for giving so much of love, and I will see you guys in my next vlog. Bye bye, and take care till then. I love you all. Bye.